welcome, etc., etc. Import your model and separate the head, hair, and body into separate meshes and export them as 3ds file. This is for having the correct format when exporting the file later. Now import the model from Resident Evil using the script. Now wait.
And wait. And wait. If you are still waiting, make some coffee.
Make your own damn coffee and leave us be.
You got plenty of time anyway, so.
Blah blah.
That's all.
I'll only use smaller words so that you'll be sure to understand, you warthog-faced buffoon. Well anyway, now import your own model. In this tutorial we will only use the body part without the head as an example.
Resize your model to match it with Jill's model.
I was about to say that, you.
Wanna hear a fun fact?
God no.
There's only one letter that doesn't appear in any US state name.
I don't care. Click on the wrench on the upper right corner and reset the X form. Below, click Reset Selected and head over to your modifier list. Right click X form and collapse all. Now choose the modifier Unwrap UVW. Reset the UV and change the channel to 2. Add a Skin Wrap modifier. Now before we go in to use the modifier, hide all unnecessary meshes of Chill's model that is.
Wanna hear another fact?
I will fry your processor if you start this crap again. Now select again your model and click on Add and select all of Chill's meshes. Distance info. Below has to be set to 0.05.
I knew that. In fact, I created my own mod already. Really?
Oh really? Well, that's bullshit. Click on Weight All Points and then convert to skin. This can sometimes takes a while. Now you can edit the weight of the bonus to your liking. Keep in mind that you can't add custom bonus to it. Otherwise the export won't work. At the very bottom click on Advanced Property. Bone effect limit should be at
8 and then remove 0 weight. I'm smart. Oh, and add a modifier with the name Edit Normals.
Would you please shut the fuck up? Thank you. Change the pixels from default 4 to 2 and hit Target. Activate Use Threshold and change the number above to 0.001. Click on Selected to your left. Open up the chromatic view. You have created only one load so far. We need 5 in total though. The name of the mesh will determine which texture file is needed to be visible on your model. Press the keys you see on the screen. We are copying our model and renaming it with the same name but as a different load group.
I knew that as well.
She won't be bothering anyone anymore. Now that we have done 5 loads, select them all and run the script again. Click on Export. The very important thing is that you try to replace the same file of Chill's model which you have imported at the beginning. Depending on your PC, the export might take a while. When the message Done appears, you are actually done with the model. Just rename it and place it into the correct path now or later. Last thing will be the textures. We use the name of the body meshes of chill. So most likely the texture file we need to use is the body file. It's so quiet I kinda enjoy it. Hey, wanna hear a fun fact? Copy the Resident Evil texture file over into the TexPatch file. A DDS file will suddenly appear. It's magic. Open Photoshop and drag and drop the DDS file into it. Tick transparency as alpha layer. Because yes. Now drag and drop your own texture which belongs to your model over Chill's DDS texture. Because WS. Ignore the alpha channel in this case. Either clothes nor the hair uses them on this model. Important thing when you save the file. Again you overwrite the original DDS texture and drag and drop the new DDS into the DDS patch file. Now do the same with the roughness map. Congrats, you're done. Now pack the file into the very same path and called via the streaming folder for high quality textures. Test your mod. Remember, we only changed the body model. The end.